we shot the movie Fame while I was just before I did West Side Story. And on the set of the movie Fame, I was supposed to be the nemesis for Coco. I was the senior who was supposed to be like the big thing. And Coco was going to show me who was the real star. But by the time Alan Parker got to my number, he already had a 10-hour movie. They let me keep the dress and said, "We love you, Debbie. Good luck. You're going to do something." So I played, it looks like I was the teacher's assistant. That's what it looked like. I just had one word, wicked.
What do you call that? Wicked.
Now that's real proof that there's no small parts in the theater or in the business, because all I said was wicked. I reacted to Jean Anthony Ray dancing, said wicked, and then that turned into a series, and my whole career as a choreographer, as a director, as a producer, and all I said was wicked. I said it the right way.
You nailed it.
I nailed it. That one word.
So what happened? How'd you find out that it was going to a TV series?
Well, it was in the middle of a strike. I can't remember. It was the actor strike.
The writer strike.
The writer strike. There was a big strike, and nobody was supposed to be meeting. And I was clandestinely called to go to this luncheon meeting, and I was whispered to that they were going to do a series, and they wanted the dance teacher to be a little bit hotter, and would I play the part? And I was like, really? I said, sure. I said, but could I do the choreography? And they said, you want to do the... They didn't even care about the choreography. They didn't even think it was a big deal. And I said, yeah, hello. The agent was like, but, you know, they're not going to pay you hardly anything. I said, it's not about the money. I want to do that work. Can I do at least most of them? So it turned out that I became the choreographer. The choreography became my whole career, because then I became a director because of my work as a choreographer. Because I came on the scene here and just changed the way they did things. They had not done this much musical production since those MGM great movies. And no one was there to teach me how to do it. So I just came up with it on my own. I had worked with Alan Johnson on Three Girls Three. Paid a lot of attention to how he put those numbers together and what the cameras, these big cranes, and what they were doing. And I'd studied directing at Howard University, where I went to college. So I translated my own idea of writing out my notes and the numbers, and the cameraman was, I remember Bill Spencer saying, "Kid, what are you doing? We can't have these two dancing together. This girl is too black and he's too white." I said, "Well, Bill, you're going to have to find a way to light it, because that's my best dancer, both of them. And they're going to dance together every week. So you're going to have to find a new way to light it." Now I was Miss Sassy. I just got off the bus. But I was running things, honey. I just had that kind of authority or just sense of confidence about what I was doing. And I was leading a band of angels, all those dancing angels. I mean, they were a handful. Oh, my God. They were a handful.
How so?
Because the stories on Fame were very much like what was going on behind the scenes. Jean Anthony Ray, who was like my son, was so raw, so talented, so magnificent, and so undisciplined. It was just how he had grown up. And when he didn't feel like it, he wasn't going to do it. So I had to teach him differently. So I kicked his ass on a weekly basis, and he loved me for it.
So off camera and on camera, you were the same role.
I was the same role. I mean, I was teaching Erica Gimple, Coco, how to dance. I was teaching Lori Singer how to dance. On the weekends, I never got a day off. Never. Because I had to always get them up to speed. You know, I was always working with the music. And then just managing those young personalities. You know, if you got a house full of teenagers and you got maybe three, but now you have like 8 and then 15 dancers, and then you take them on the road to London to play the Royal Albert Hall, and they're on a bus going crazy from London to Liverpool. Oh, it was a handful, but it was one of the greatest times of my life.